least that we're getting used to the flag, so
Slate, please, state your name and spell it.
Hi, I am Taylor Hay. It's T as in Tammy, A as in apple, Y as in yellow, L as in lemon, O as in orange, R as in red, and then Hay as H as in horse, A as in apple, Y as in yellow. I can sign that for you if you want as well.
Are we selling product?
I guess so. Trader Joe's sparkling lemon mineral bottle.
Why should I recycle that bottle?
You should recycle this bottle because if you don't, and if it just goes in the landfill, that means it is going into our soil and it's not biodegradable, therefore it will just forever be there, which will eventually pretty much just go into our like waterways, and that's not a good thing because we have miles and miles of waste such as that in our waterways and our oceans that have created this.
Why is it a big problem going in my car window?
Because it's not biodegradable.
Can't, but it'll just wash down the drain.
The drain goes to our ocean or lakes or ponds, and if it goes into our ocean, there'll be no water for fish to be able to swim in because it'll just compact all together. And I mean, like I said, there's miles and miles of stuff like this and bottles and cardboard and everything that is not biodegradable in our washways.
Fish don't eat those. They float.
Yeah, but it's still, if there's many of these, say thousands and thousands of these in the water, they're going to compact together and the fish won't have any room to move.
Okay, you don't and do they will... so here, let me help you with another problem. What if a fish eats this?
That's poisonous, not only for...
Good. Okay. Explain why a fish shouldn't have that floating in the water.
Just making sure that there's nothing in it. It's poisonous. I mean, it's paper.
What is it?
It's a tobacco.
What's in the paper?
Well, nothing is poisonous, but styrofoam, I think. I don't know.
No. Take a look at it, tear it apart, see what that really is.
I don't know what's in it.
I want you to tear it apart.
Is it nicotine?
No, it's not. Tear it apart. It's a filter. It's fiberglass. What would fiberglass do to a fish
in
its body? Aside from the fact that it'll explode with the water, it'll expand. What happens?
Yeah, and then the fish will eat it, and the fish will literally die because it's fiberglass. It'll get stuck in there.
I want you to hold it up to camera, explain what it is, so some kid who's smoking is throwing a cigarette out the window. This is a cigarette filter. Here's what happens when you carelessly throw it out of the window. Here's a bottle cap when you carelessly throw this out. This is your, moment of lapse of memory, and here's the ripple effect in the world today of everybody doing exactly what you're just throwing a piece of cigarette out. Good example.
This is what I was at, right? Right here?
Yeah, that's good.
Because this is coming from your generation to your generation. Hey, you know, I see you around school, campus, wherever, pick a place. Have you ever seen someone throw that out of a window?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. What does it do? What is it? What does it do?
Ask the camera then.
I want you to ask these people here. Okay. Look down their throat. You recognize this? Something like that.
Do you guys know what this is? Maybe what this is? Well, both of these things are hazardous to our environment. This is a cigarette filter. This is a bottle cap. I mean, you may be driving down a freeway or a road or even on campus and just throw these. Or if one of these pops off your drink, you may think, I don't need anymore. But these are crucial to what is happening to our environment. These two are just a handful of things that are getting thrown into our waterways, and fish eat these, and they expand, and the fish die. They ingest these, they can't function, and they can't digest this, therefore they die. Everything comes down to these little aspects that you guys are throwing into our environment that can't be, is not naturally selected to be in our environment. These aren't supposed to be there. But because you guys just carelessly throw them out the windows, they're there. And now my generation and upcoming generations have to deal with the consequences because your carelessness of throwing these out the window. It's not fair. I'm sorry, but it's not. And I don't think we should have issues in the asthmatics of the world should have issues because you guys are too lazy to properly dispose of these. I don't think that's fair to us or upcoming generations.
You just gave me an idea, and it's not something I had thought about until just now. And the idea is we should start a section on the site. Something in the vein of what she just did, And maybe we call them. And they can be like anywhere from 10, 15, 30, 60, 90 seconds. Vignettes people can submit to us from around the world. And we'll put up their stories about Maratus, Rainforest Should Not Die, public service announcements. And we're giving people a platform to make their message be heard to the world at large. I don't care if we get 1 million of those videos up, it'll make a big website.
Even if it's just but iPhone videos.
Rotate them. Yeah, rotate.
But it'll also get people to know. We can archive, believe me. Storage for me is not a problem. I'd rather have 1 million than
okay. Isn't it easier to have them posted on...
But let me finish my thought, please let me finish my thought, please. Because I lose them really quickly if we keep interrupting us. Then we can also offer them to like NBC and other stations. They can lift them and put them on broadcast as public service announcements that cross promote the film. So the thing we maybe put rules up on the site, they cross promote the film. They have to give the URL, their name, any pitch they want to give. We like it, we'll put it on the site. If we don't like it, they can put it on their social media. They can still put it on the social media. They can link to us if they put it up. It makes the whole thing more viral. So I want you to kick off this whole thing, and maybe you'll do one also. What's your name? And I'd like you to help out our film. We're at this rainforestshouldnotdie.com. Keep coming here for information, share with your friends. Hey, I want to share a little tip with you about public service announcement, about how these silly things can be so toxic. Maybe that's the quick short pitch if you're doing like a 90-second or a 30-second. These are toxic. Well, it may seem like a cigarette butt, and that's toxic unto itself. Throwing it out is toxic. Throwing this out is toxic. Something as simple as a bottle cap can kill.
Do you want me to pitch it as I want you guys to go around your town and just film just 30-second videos of what you guys
no,
feel?
You don't.
No, don't pitch the video. Just do your own.
Just do my own thing. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you. Oh, God, I have it. That's cool.
And yeah, I mean, I think that's a great approach to say, see this? It's a filter. See this? It's a bottle cap. These can kill. Those are powerful words.
Yeah.
These can kill.
It's maratusrainforest.com or...
Maratusrainforest should not die.
Should not die.com.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm having a Charlie horse in my back that is killing me right now. Go ahead. I'll try not to moan too loud.
You see these two things? These are deadly. These can kill you. Not only our generation, but the generations to come. They may just seem like a cigarette butt or a bottle cap, but they can kill you. Just as easily as a normal cigarette can kill you, the butt can kill you if you just throw it out into the street. Or if you just drop one of these because it just spun off your soda. No matter what, they're totally different things, but they both can kill you.
But you forgot to say that it went into the ocean and you got to kill, maybe overkill, Kilroy.
It doesn't kill them.
It doesn't
kill us.
It kills the fish.
It kills us.
It can kill us, but the more long-term ripple effect is it starts to kill other people on the food chain, like fish dying. And then when other fish die that may depend on those fish, then other fish die.
Bacteria.
And fish we depend on may, you know. Mm-hmm. So it affects the whole food chain. These two little things... not only may kill you if a baby chokes on it or you die of cancer, but it affects the whole food chain when you throw it out the window.
Yeah.
Because throwing it out the window means...
yeah, a fish can die.
Yeah.
A dog can die.
Got it.
Thank you.
What if a squirrel could die.
What if she closes with, to save the planet, visit, and then gives the website?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or...
to help us.
Yeah, to help us, let's get the world aware.
Do a bridge so that you have an action item.
Okay. So we can do a pickup on what you did and do that and then just do a straight clean pickup.
Hold them up. For me, just
and can you direct the next couple? I've got to go out and stretch. I'm having Charlie
Horses. You just kind of like the...
can I put on Get Back in Time? Then have her do a promo, kind of like Elta Reed did, but shorter for the website.
Like this.
And then ask her a series of questions like I did last time. I need to take a break.
Yeah,
thanks.
Bring it back.
I'm just exhausted.
And do that.
It's nothing personal.
Come back. Okay. Ready?
Let me just clear Seth and WTN will be there. They will direct each other. You'll be in great hands. I'll be back before you're done. I promise.
Ready? Actually, I want to do this entire.
actions such as carelessly throwing these out the window not only can affect us, but they go into our water ways, therefore affecting the fish. And then the animals that live on fish to feed on, they die as well. So not only are you affecting the fish, you're affecting the bears, the wild dogs, all of those mammals that rely on fish. And then you have just normal bacteria and algae in the ocean whose waters are now polluted, therefore they die. And then you have the larger animals that may feed on bears, like the vultures. When the bears die, then they're not going to have food because the food chain just keeps rippling down because of these two things. You may think of these as a cigarette filter and a bottle cap. What harm can they do? Well, if you really think about it, these get passed down the food chain, slowly killing every animal that they reach. To find out more about how to help our environment, check out www.maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
Give me the tag again.
To find out more on how to help our environment, check out maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.
I need it all together. Okay. Stand by. And go.
To find out more how to save our environment, check out maratasrainforestshouldnotdie.com.